Hi guys, welcome back to my channel for another journal with me video. And this week I am using this 5th anniversary Lady Falcon's Travelers limited edition notebook cover. And at that time it's still called Lady Falcon's Travelers. I think now Monique has changed her shop name to Falcon's Traveler. And here I'm just taking out my very bulky insert to set up my spread. I don't have any idea what type of spread I want to do. I know it's vintage, but I just know I want to incorporate these new stamps that I got from Raw Market Shop. It's the tap stamp with the floral thingy. And I've stamped them down. The first cover I used the craft paper, while the other two I used the vellum paper. And I created this little tiny pockets using Via Memory Keeper's punch. I did modify it a bit so that the tab will peep through. And here I want to decorate the cover a little bit with other stamps, and I'm using the Stays On ink pad. So I hope you guys have a very wonderful Christmas. I did enjoy my holiday here, and yep, have some quality time with my family, with my son as well, yep. And here I'm using another stamp and another Stays On. I think it's the, what color is that? It's like something like a brown color. Grenache. I don't know how to pronounce that. Yep. And this stamp is from Taobao. And now I'm going to decorate the little pockets using this apothecary definition stamp, again from Raw Market Shop. I accidentally got some stamps on the bottom side of my stamp. It stays on, so it's a bit hard to get off, but well, I think it's okay because I bought the stamp to use it, not to baby it, right? That's how I always try to encourage myself to use the millions of stamps that I have. It wasn't perfectly stamped down. There's some wording that I blurred, but it's okay, I guess. And here, this copyright stamp, I love it, is again from Taobao, so I'm gonna stamp that down using another Stays On. Now normally I use my Sachiada ink pad, but if I'm not too sure whether how the paper reacts to ink pads, whether it will smear or bleed through or anything, I will usually use Stays On, because Stays On usually dries on practically any surface, so I don't have to worry about, you know, the ink not drying well, or you know, smearing, or yep, things like that. So at first I do not know how I want the three tabs to stay together. I do not want to staple them or glue them together, so then I remember I have these very cute tiny paper clips, so I'm gonna use that to clip them together. At first I want to put outside the pockets, but then I changed my mind. So I think it looks way better to have the paper clips on the tab itself. So cute. It really, really looks like those office, you know, folder with tabs. Absolutely love these paper clips and this tab stamp from Raw Market. These paper clips I got from a local seller in, I think, Instagram or Shopee. A lot of sellers have this. So yeah, but I can't remember which one I got it from. And here are another Raw Market Shop stamp. Again, it's the same release with the tab stamp, and I'm gonna stamp that on this onion skin paper. Again, I will use my Stays On because I'm sure the Sachiada ink pad won't dry on the onion skin paper. And I'm gonna put it down firmly. Now this, if you see the background, is the of my table. It's actually it's a cork like desk pad, so it's a bit softer compared to my previous cutting mat. And I felt that the effect to stamping on it is absolutely awesome. You know, I think to have a good stamp out image, you have to have something like a softer underlay board. Yep, and your stamp image will normally turn out quite good. And here I want to get this one of this grid paper to form my collage. So I've decided to put my tabs on the right side and the grid paper together with that list, the Roman list on the left side. And I want to have to decorate a bit on the grid paper. At first, I didn't know which lamp papery stamp I want to use. Then I decided to use the horizontal one. But before that, I'm going to put down this numerical stamp on the bottom part of the grid paper. This numerical stamp is from one of the set from Banfan. Banfan, B-A-N-F-A-N, yep. I'm going to use the red color ink pad. Then this, the barcode stamp, again from Banfan. It's the same set, together with the numerical the numerical stamp. And Sachihata gray ink pad. Awesome. Next comes this lamp papery. I decided to use the horizontal one. And I'm going to use the black color ink, alright? Am I using the black? Yes, I'm using Sachihata black color ink pad. Next, I want to put this postage or postmark stamp. And they are small in size and so cute, and I really, really love to use them. I think I've used this quite a lot in my other spread. Sachihata blue ink pad. Perfect. It looks so cute. The size is just perfect for the pockets. And another postmark stamp on the grid paper. Again, perfect. And I'm gonna use another postmark stamp that has the lines on both of these pockets and this grid paper. And I'm gonna use red color ink pad this time. But I do not want it to be too dark, so I stamp it on an unused a rough paper first, so that it's lighter and it looks really like an actual postmark. And I really, really like how this turns out. It looks so cute. In goes my tab folder. And here I am going to create a collage on my right spread. This paper that I'm tearing now is actually a pre-printed vintage paper from one of the junk journal, I think, pack that I got. And this grid-like paper, calligraphy paper pad, I got it recently from Moshilicious, and I really, really love this. I think if you guys have been following me, I have a lot of this design, this paper, I mean memo pad or paper pad design. And at first I thought I accidentally tear out two pieces, but then it's not, so it's actually pretty thick. And I think for its price, this is pretty good quality. And here I've taken out a piece of this Awagami factory paper in yellow color, and I want to incorporate it to form part of my collage. I'm still not sure how I want everything to be, you know, in place, but this for sure is going to be the background, so I'm going to stick this down first before I move on to my next step. Normally if I can't decide how I want the things to be, I will, you know, try to put something down first, the things that I'm sure of, and then ideas will slowly form. I think I've mentioned this quite a lot of times. That's how I set up my spread. If I don't have anything in mind, yeah, I'll start to put things down, then, you know, things will slowly flow. And here I'm going to distress the paper pad, calligraphy paper pad. I'm not too sure if it's called calligraphy paper pad. You know, when during my schooling time, we do have this paper pad, but of course it's in a bigger size, like A4 or A5 sizes, A4 or A5 size. We used to write essays on them, Chinese essays. So we don't use it for calligraphy though. Calligraphy is a different type of paper, and the squares are bigger. I'm not too sure, but I tend to call it the calligraphy paper. Else, how do you call it? Essay paper? When I bought this, the name of this paper is in Mandarin, and the meaning is actually essay paper. But anyway, I guess you can call it calligraphy paper. I think people understand. And here I'm distressing the grid paper as well. And I didn't distress that onion skin paper because distress ink doesn't dry well on onion skin paper. Yep. So here I have stuck down the calligraphy paper as well as the origami factory paper, and these two I'm gonna staple it together with the Tim Holtz tiny attacher, and I'm gonna stick it down. I think with my glue tape. Off camera? Yes, off camera. And nope, not yet. I'm gonna put down this classic-y washi tape first. So have you, have you guys prepared for 2021? I think I'm almost done. I just need to, I've set up my monthly insert, which I did a video for that. And I'm gonna set up my daily insert, which is this one. It's not a daily one, but yeah, I'm gonna set up that soon too. Here I use this lamb papery label sticker to form part of the collage. I let it peep through the grid paper. I think it looks awesome. All these label stickers or paper in that container are freebies, guys. And I want to use a piece of vintage stickers as well. And all these vintage stickers in this container are freebie too. So yeah, choosing this green one. Green, brown, vintage stickers. And I'm putting it down with my glue tape. And next, what did I do? Okay, I used the other half of this origami factory paper on the right side to form part of the background for my mini folder or mini tab folder, right? Yes. Then I want to use another piece of washi tape. This time I'm using the gray grid washi tape again from Classic Key. Oopsie. And I'm gonna put my pocket folder down with my glue tape. I can't get over how cute this is. I really love raw market shop stamp. And I am a bit lucky that it's in Singapore, so the delivery charge is actually reasonable to ship from Singapore to Malaysia. We are just neighbors, so it's not that expensive. And it will reach me pretty fast too. And here I want to ensure that the tab peek through the folders, the pocket. So I use that paper clip to secure it on the pocket. There we go. It looks so cute, right? And here I want to use this Tim Holtz wording sticker to put on top of my left page spread, because I think it's a bit empty there. And as usual, I'll use the black background sticker. I'll choose two strip. Can't remember what did I choose. I just wanna make nice things. Okay, next. Creativity takes courage. So I think it does. I mean, you know, the tool to does create some logic behind, right? I mean, it does create logic. I want to create nice things, so creativity takes courage. Next, I am going to distress the sides of my spread. This distress ink is walnut stain. It's a darker brown compared to vintage photos or frayed burlap. Frayed burlap is more like greenish color. So for walnut stain, I do not have to put much force in it, and the color will be there. It's dark brown. Yeah. And guys, I have a few more videos to upload before the end of December. Today is like the 27th. And hopefully I'll be able to upload one today. So I'm gonna hopefully I'll be able to upload another one today and maybe another one tomorrow. I don't want to commit too much because sometimes there are a lot of unexpected things pop up, and when I promise I want to do something and then all of a sudden something pops up, like the other video that I've recorded so many times. I didn't manage to get one that I am confident to upload. So I want to do that today, hopefully, before 2021 starts. Anyway, I'm done with today's spread. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. And until I see you guys, do take care. Stay safe, stay healthy, stay happy. Thank you guys for watching. Bye.